Ugh. Oh my god, all that talking and no audio. Okay, so. Again. So. Anyways. I am Miss Noblekind, and I'm playing Cyberpunk 2077. And I am playing as a nomad. I'm trying to do a no-kill run. Not doing so great. Have to start over because I'm very committed to not killing anyone. And when I say start over, like to the last save point, which I have to do with this one because I have to go with Jackie to the Ripjaw guy and my driving was bad and I was running over people. And then I got the Grand Theft Auto alert with but instead of stars showing up, it was like a map. And people screaming at me. And so I thought it was the best time to end there. And just kind of reevaluate. So. We are going to go. See. Rip Doctor. I'm going to go. Which. Level 2. Level autosave. 2. Level 3. I'm going to go here. And see if I can start without killing anyone. If not, then I'll load a little bit back further. But I'm going to try really, really hard not to do that. Okay. I feel like the cutscene for this apartment is much prettier than what the actual apartment looks like. I just have a sense. Alright, so we have to get into the car. Alright, cool. This is what we wanted. Alright, is there anything for me to pick up? Let me walk around real quick. Make sure I picked everything up that I could before I go. Nope. Alright. Okay, in the driver's seat. Alright. Oh, it's kind of splotchy here. Probably my computer. Alright. We're gonna... Maybe that was my problem. No. Alright. I have to... Okay. Go past those guys. Going really slow. Oh, I wonder if you could go down that way, but I'm not going to do that. Not in front of the cops. Alright, took that very hard. Alright. Horrible driver, guys. Horrible drivers. Why don't do it in real life? Alright. Which probably explains why. Bradbury. Ooh. Kind of like Ray Bradbury. This is the cops. All right. feel like I need to find a garage or something. Okay, so I want to be able to find a place to park. I don't feel like, maybe that there's a place there. I don't know why these cars are randomly stopped. Where's the Rip Doctor again? I've gotten myself lost. But I didn't kill anybody. Alright. What is that star? What does that star mean? Let me So, such a shitty fucking job. Oh my god. That was so shitty. I think I was supposed to, like, I don't know, parallel park or something? Oh, death. I don't want death. Version of the guy in Keanu Reeves or something. Showing my gameplay. What an idiot. Still new to this streaming thing, guys. That's one of more. Spunky Monkey. Yeah, I guess I'm looking up the grid. What's that? Oh, that's so gross. Ooh, he's got a lot of holes in him. Cyberkinetic implants or mechanical replacements to give you superhuman-like abilities. Okay, although it's common practice in 2077, the installation of cyberware is still invasive and sometimes dangerous medical procedure. Only specialists known as rip doctors are trusted to install cyberware safety.
Alright. Okay.
So. Ooh, I have to choose available items. Limited cyberware would be part of the world and be installed by the Rip Doctor. So, I guess install? Okay, installed. Alright. Do I have a tray?
landscape.
It's very detailed.
Increases chances of ricochet shots. Difficult links to users off the gun plant. Installed. Alright. Escape. Alright, so what am I supposed to do? So how do I get out of this? This is all the junk. I don't understand this.
Looks like almost a tattoo parlor set up here.
Lucky cats.
I'm seeing outside of my body.
Oh, that's not cool. Scanning people with their optical cyborg can provide you a lot of useful information, such as how strong an enemy might be, who's in your crew, what type of weapon to use. As a skill net runner, you can use a list of quick hacks which you can use against your enemies.
Okay. Civilian. Percent resistance to fire, 50% to death.
Database of individuals with bounties assigned to them is now available to use. You can identify those one persons with a scanner. Since all you wanted dead or alive, the methods we use to claim rewards are kind of up to you. We are not killing anybody, so why are you doing bounty hunters?
Virus.
And then they have a quarter top. I don't see the difference between why. I'm with you, it's kind of monk.
Nothing a little sweet hanging out here. Oh, finally.
find it if I do.
Even before our many beans and Babylon lost their minds over this subject, while many others were inching closer to the same fate, the burning question today, the question racked the brains of both pitiful scientists and normal beings of Babylon is this: do we have a soul or not? There were all sorts of fascinating theories on the subject, new ones appearing all the time, each and every one of them tempting hypothesis has its course. Despite the overwhelming number and diversity of these beliefs, they were all based on one or two completely opposing premises. The first was called atheism, while the other was idealism or dualism. All dualistic hypotheses held that souls existed, and of course that it was immoral and can suffer beings even after the death of the being. Meanwhile, the atheist theories held the complete opposite view. Short, my boy.
The soul's manual by Morgan Lacan. Intro. Think you've got what it takes to be a legendary soul, huh? Sure you did. Otherwise, why pick up this book? You're looking for respect, for fear, for a way to the top. Maybe you heard someone's quote. Maybe about winning battles only a glance before a single shot has been fired. Well, fine. I'll let you in on a secret. It's possible, and you can do it too. But only if you got the guts to survive going to hell back more times than you count. Is this like a gangster's self-help thing? Thousands of bites, millions of bullets, hundreds of gallons of blood, yours included. That's what you have to look forward to. And you need a solid ripper, one you can trust, and one you can make lifelong shumbatas out of. One who tells you every week it's a miracle you ain't dead by now. At least this will say if you're lucky. Nowadays, every kid with a big iron, a thin leather coat, and a micro missile launcher thinks they're a hot shot soul. But you know what? Just because you've killed a few goons with a smile on your lip, don't make you one. Anyone can kill. I knew this rocker boy once who blew up a whole fucking platoon of corporate trash. Did that make him a soul? No, it made him dead. So, still thinking about what it takes to carve your name into the solo history? Good. And this book is for you.
It is a self-help book for the gangsters.
Wow, that is crazy.
Isn't there one more shard? Or is that all of them?
Alright.
Huh. Bubblegum? Wontons. Is there a glitch? My inventory means. Non-lethal. Yeah, there we go. Still there. It's always ways, 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 ways,
Kind of looks like Rick Ross.
That one singer, Barry White.
What?
was supposed to respond to that. Perform certain actions to reward you with street cred. Build your street cred to make a name of yourself in the night. See, doing so opens new opportunities. Escape. Alright, I think I'll go to this bar and then call it a night. Probably should. Escape. Select from the highlighted row across that descent.
Exit face.
I'm gonna have to do this over again, that was the wrong grenade.
Start this again. Cause I killed somebody. Pretty sure I killed that dude. That was supposed to be non-lethal.
Okay, so I'm gonna have to start this over. So escape.
Save game.
Oh.
Damn it.
Alright.
So I'm gonna have to finish.
I don't understand what that is.
Alright, alright. I killed somebody, so yes, there'll be unsafe progress. I don't understand it. I guess it's some kind of glitch, like it wouldn't let me give the person to the driver in the boot. I don't know if it's a red comeback.
or something, and I lit the person on fire, and there was a big pool of blood. That is not how I wanted to go. So I killed somebody, go back to a previous save, so I don't kill that person, and figure out how I can sneak attack them or phase them, and I guess there's two, can knock them out, and then take her to the car. I don't know, that was weird, but that's it for now, until next time guys,
this is Miss Noble Kind, and I am trying to no kill Nomad Run Cyberpunk 2077.